Hey, River View, Mr. O'Malley filling in today, being Friday, September 16th, and we're on a day four schedule. All that is highly suspect. I'm not sure if it's correct. Some homecoming information. This year's homecoming dance will take place on Saturday, October 8th, from 7 o'clock to 10 o'clock. No one will be permitted to enter the dance after 8 o'clock p.m. In the evening in the high school cafeteria, members of the student council will be transforming this venue into an evening under the stars. If you're a student in grades 9 through 12, members of the student council will be selling homecoming tickets before and after school in room 222 beginning on Tuesday, September 20th through Monday, October 3rd. If you are bringing a guest from another school, you must have your guest permission form submitted to Mrs. Walsh before you can purchase your tickets. Tickets are $5 a person or $10 per couple. Any students in grades 9 to 12 who's planning to bring a guest to the homecoming dance on Saturday, October 8th, must pick up a guest permission slip form in room 222. Okay, please complete this form neatly. If this form is not legible, your guests will not be permitted to attend the dance. A photo identification, driver's license, or school ID must be included with the application. Your completed application must be submitted by Friday, September 30th. Only one guest pass per student will be issued. This is if you're bringing a guest from another school. This year's homecoming queen will be crowned during the halftime show at the football game on Friday, October 7th. The game will be played under the lights and will begin at 7 o'clock. Attention students in grades 9 through 12 looking for a way to complete the required job shadow. The Allegheny Intermediate Unit is offering mini apprenticeships in the following areas: architecture, associated artists, future teachers academy, theater at warp speed, opera, pharmacy, writing for publication, and zoo animal care. If you're interested, please see or send a message in Teams to Dr. McNally for further information. There's an SAT prep course available. The dates are Saturdays, September 24th through October 29th. It's from 9 a.m. to noon. It costs $200, and you'll be exploring test-taking strategies, learning tips to improve study skills, and most studies do show that SAT prep courses will help you raise your score. So if you're interested in taking an SAT prep course at Penn State New Kensington, please see your guidance counselor for more information. Did you miss the deadline to purchase a yearbook? If so, you're in luck. A limited number of yearbooks are available for purchase. In order to pick up a copy, you must bring cash or check made payable to Riverview Yearbook to Ms. Gardner's room, room 207, before first period or after school. Cost is $65. Books will be sold on a first-come, first-served basis. The Raider football team has been off to a good start this year with an impressive victory followed by an incredibly close defeat last weekend. Enzo Leo and Luke Migley went out to the hallways to get some predictions for the team's next game. Let's hear some score predictions from students and teachers in this new segment, Call Your Shot.
What's up, Riverview? Today, we're going asking students and teachers the upcoming score and predictions for Clareton. Let's get it.
How we doing, Riverview? We just lost to Northgate 32-26 in a hard-fought battle. We sustained some injuries, but I think we got it. I'll be asking about touchdown predictions today, and let's go Raiders!
I'm here with Johnny Bertucci, running back on the Raider football team. What do you think the score will be for your upcoming game against Clareton?
You know, I think Riverview has this one in the bag, 21-7.
I love it, Johnny B. I love it. Thank you. I'm here with Mr. Carlin. I'm going to be asking him today, who do you think is going to win, and what do you think the score will be?
And it's a tough one. Riverview's gotten some serious injuries, some really important players have been hurt. But, you know, Coach George has done a great job getting these guys believe in that team, and I think they believe in themselves. I'm predicting a big upset this weekend. I figure Clareton, Riverview 33, Clareton 30.
I love a close game, close win.
It's going to be close. You know it's going to be close.
Thank you, Mr. Carlin. All right, Riverview, I'm here with Miss Spawn, and I'm going to ask her who's going to win the upcoming games against Clareton, and what's the score going to be?
I was a little nervous. I get nervous in front of cameras. Oh, the game. The game Saturday. I mean, it was impressive, the score, and I heard there was a lot of injuries. And so we just put that behind us. We get healed up, and this Saturday, home, It's going to be 24-20 Riverview.
Yes. Let's go, Miss Spawn.
Let's go, boys.
Yes.
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 What's up, Riverview? I'm here with Mr. Turk, and I'm going to be asking him, what do you think the score prediction will be against Clairton, and who do you think is going to win?
I'm going to go with our Riverview Raiders at a score of 24-17.
I love it. I love it.
I love it, too. Yep. I love it, too.
Yep. Thank you, sir.
All right. I'm back here with Mrs. Spawn, and I'm going to ask her,
who is going to score the most touchdowns for Riverview against Clairton on Saturday?
Rocco Searcy. He's going to have 3 touchdowns.
Heard it right here. Rocco passing or rushing for 3 touchdowns. Let's go, Raiders.
We're back here with my man, Johnny B. He had a great game last Saturday. And I'm going to ask you, who is going to have the most touchdowns against the Clairton Bears?
You know, I'm going to have to go with probably a consistent player on our team, which was one of our running backs, Landon Johnson. I got with the most touchdowns.
How many?
I'd say 2, and Rocco's probably going to throw 1, I'm thinking.
There we have it, folks. Let's go Raiders! All right, I'm back here with Mr. Turk, and I'm going to be asking him who is going to score the most touchdowns against Clairton and who it's going to be.
And I'm going to go with my man, Kevin Tomlinson, 2 touchdowns.
There we have it. Let's go Raiders.
All right, Riverview, we're back with Mr. Carlin, and I'm going to ask him who is going to score the most touchdowns and who it will be against Clairton.
Well, I tell you, again, I think this is a team that's got a lot of offensive potential and firepower, and they can score from a bunch of different places. But I really, you got to go with Landon Johnson and back up maybe Kevin Tomlinson. I think he's going to hit, I think Rocco's going to hit big with a couple of passes, and I think Kevin's going to hit the end zone.
Great answer, Mr. Carlin. Thank you, sir.
Good luck this weekend, Raiders football team. Well, that's all for today's news announcements, everyone. I'm Mr. O'Malley. Please remember to stand for the pledge. Have a great weekend.